Asian, I grew up on anime and would draw anime all day long. And who doesn't want to be an anime character for a day? So for this Halloween tutorial, I'll show you how to achieve fun anime eyes. So let's begin. Wearing fun circle lenses, which will make your eyes bigger, will really help in this tutorial. So I'm wearing Barbie circle lens in black, and you can purchase this at pinkyparadise.com. I'm going to start off with moisturizer and using Biotherm Aqua Source and applying it all over my face evenly. And since we're going to focus on our eyes a lot, we want to apply eye cream. I'm using Burt's Bees Radiance, and it's just a normal cream, but I like to use it as an eye cream. And I'm just gonna... Next, I'm going to apply foundation. I'm using Revlon Photo Ready in Nude, and I'm going to apply in the brush. I'm going to pat it and apply it all over my face in the areas I need it, under my eyes, around my nose area, and forehead. For concealer, I'm going to be using Erase Paste by Benefit, and I'm going to just dot in the places I need it and blend it in all together. I'm going to apply under my eyes, around my nose, my chin, any blemishes that I have, and on my Cupid's bow to bring emphasis towards my lips. Next, grab your favorite powder. I'm using MAC Studio Fix, and using the sponge that comes with it, you can use any sponge that you have or a brush. I'm just going to pat it to set my foundation and all my concealer. I'm just going to gently pat it all over my skin, and don't forget your neck as well. Next for eyebrows, I'm going to be using Skin Food Choco Brow Powder, and use any brow powder that you have. And I'm just going to go with stroking motions toward my eyebrows to make them very natural as possible. And later on, with the brush, when I'm going to brush my eyebrows, you want to brush up and then go down. Next, I'm going to contour our face. I'm going to be using MAC Sculpt. You can use a bronzer, a matte bronzer, a light brown matte eyeshadow that you have, and using a big brush, we're gonna contour our face. Contouring our face is we're gonna go all around the outer area of our face, starting from our forehead, to our jawlines, to our cheekbones. So you just kinda wanna exaggerate, apply a bit more than usual since it's an anime look, and just gonna apply it all around your face, and you're gonna focus a lot under your cheekbones and your jawline. And we're also going to contour our nose. Grab a smaller brush, and we're going to go from the beginning of our eyebrows and go all the way straight down. And towards the tip of your nose, you just want to end it like in an arrow shape. Kind of make it arrow shape. Since anime characters have really small, thin noses, you want to really thin down your nose. Next, we're going to highlight our face. I'm using Benefit's High Beam, and you can use a cream eyeshadow or a regular eyeshadow. to highlight your face. I'm just using Benefit. And you just want to highlight your nose bridge and your cheeks. And this will bring light, will bring definition and emphasis on those areas. So we're just gonna dot it in on those areas, and I like to blend in with my fingers. You can use a brush if you like, but I like the warmth of my fingers and it helps blend it in way better than a brush. So this is up to you, and I like to emphasize my Cupid's bow on my lips and my chins as well. Next, we'll prime our eyes. I'm going to use MAC Paint Pot. You can use a cream shadow or any primer that you have. And I'm just using MAC Paint Pot for now. And I'm just going to apply it all on my lid and apply especially on your lower lids. So next, grab a white eyeliner. I'm just using Face Shop white eyeliner. You can use any white eyeliner that you have. We're going to start off with our lower waterline and just fill it in. And just go all the way down towards your lower lids and just emphasize and fill in that area. How big you want the area to be wide is up to you. I'm just gonna do this much. And I'm just going to go all the way down and go towards my inner corners and emphasize that area. And not only am I going to focus in the inner corners, I'm going to apply it on my outer corners and sort of extend my eyes and give it this fun illusion. After you're done with the step, you're gonna look really creepy, but that's okay. Anyways, use your fingers and sort of blend out the edges, kind of soften it out. Next, grab really neutral eyeshadows. I'm using Revlon Coffee Bean, and I'm just gonna use the two colors on the top and apply it on top of the white eyeliner, sort of making it blend in a bit more with my skin tone and making it look a bit more natural because white seems a bit too white. But if you like it being white, you could just leave it as it is. Next, with an angled brush, I'm going to grab this lilac color, and it's from the Revlon Berry Bloom palette. And I'm going to just dip it in and take off the excess. And we're going to sort of line our lower lid, sort of make a fake lash line. Next, grab your favorite gel liner. My favorite gel liner is MAC Fluid Line in Black Track. And using a brush, you really want to practice in the back of your hand or try this the night before and sort of play around with your gel liner. So we're just going to line our eyes and sort of extend it all the way towards the end and just try to make an exaggerated lash line, a fake lash line. And we're just going to go sort of straight across. After you sew, you've had a guideline, you just want to fill it in, make it thick and dark, and just extend it out. And with the gel liner, we're going to sort of draw false lashes. Now with the leftover gel liner, you want to outline your fake lower lash that you have created and sort of thinly dry it in. Next, I'm going to grab a purple eyeshadow from my Revlon Berry Bloom palette. And you can use any eyeshadow that you want, whatever you're wearing. I'm just using purple for now. And you just want to outline and fill in on top of the eyeliner. Next, I'm going to grab a light pink color. You can use a silver eyeshadow, any color that you like. And I'm going to apply it towards the inner corners and towards the inner lids. Next, we're going to grab our gel liner again and we're going to sort of outline our crease and sort of make a fake double eyelid. So you just want to start off sort of lightly lining it and testing it out slowly. And after you enjoy and like the shape, you want to go and outline it again and make it thicker or darker. Next, we apply false lashes. I'm using Ardell's false lashes. I don't know the name of the lashes, but you can use any pair of lashes that you have. And I'm using Duo Lash Glue, which dries dark. And after applying the glue, you want to wait for 20 seconds and apply the lashes. You want to apply the lashes on the fake eyelash that we have drawn and sort of follow those lines instead of your normal lash line and just glue it in. Now get your favorite mascara. I'm using Makeup Forever Aqua Smoky Lash. And blending your regular lashes with your false lashes, apply specially towards your inner lashes. Now I'm going to apply individual lashes towards the fake lash line that we created in our lower lids. Get tweezers and take a pair of lashes. Get your lash glue, wait for 20 seconds, and we're going to apply it on our lower lids. You want to apply around 3 individual lashes. You could apply more if you like, but I'm just going to apply 3. Now that's it for our eyes, and let's focus on our cheeks. We're using MAC Tippy, and it's a hot pink color blush, and we're going to apply it in the apples of our cheeks. So smile and apply on the apples of your cheeks and blend it out. For all day long lasting color, I'm going to be using lip tint. I'm using Benefit Posy Tint and applying on my lips. You can use any pink lipstick, lip gloss that you have. This is optional. And a little quick tip, if you have some mistakes, use a white eyeliner and an eraser and cover up any mistakes.